revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Together, we will change Gotham. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Your father knew which hands to shake.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous. Buy that.
This is Selina.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces. Falcone's calling card.
The chemicals. Where are they?
We're all being played in, couldn't you?
Christ Almighty!
It's the Waynes.
Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Only you now, Master Bruce.
I thought I might find you here. The news was upsetting for both of us.
But you should see this.
I know you come here for solitude, Bruce.
More allegations about his ties to the underworld.
This isn't going away.
It's all so public and messy.
People are throwing stones at my family, Alfred. I need to understand why.
It's my family, too. Don't forget that. I've been dreading this day for nearly two decades. I hoped it would never come.
Forget the papers. I want to hear it from you.
The truth is, they were billionaires, Bruce. You can't amass that kind of wealth without making certain moral compromises. It's just not possible. That kind of money taints you.
My money has never corrupted me.
And I'm proud of you. But you're hardly the norm. Hill greased the wheels of politics. Falcone was the muscle. Thomas legitimized the whole enterprise with his name. Your father, Hamilton Hill, and Falcone, they were partners. Nothing happened in Gotham without them knowing.
Working with Falcone and Hill, I expected a regular accounting, not a pact with the devil.
Your father was a good man in many ways, but this was his undoing. I want you to know, I had my suitcases ready. I couldn't stand to be around your father anymore. But then they were killed, and you were all alone. And I just couldn't walk out the door. Everything I did, everything I've ever done, was out of love for you. I hope you can forgive me.
How could I hold this against you? You're all I've got, Alfred.
Thank you. I won't let you down again. This is the first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you, I thought they'd finally arrested your father. I couldn't believe a low-life thug like Joe Chill would have the audacity to rob and kill Thomas Wayne. He was simply too well known. Too big. Yet, there it was.
If my father was that deep in crime, he would have had enemies.
Well, it's a fair assumption. You don't think? You always said it was a simple mugging. In 20 years, you've never wavered from that story.
I can recall every moment of that night in vivid detail. But maybe that's wrong.
Sometimes we block out things we don't want to face.
Maybe there was some detail I overlooked. I want him standing here, right now.
And what would the Batman do with his own parents' killer? The possibilities are frightening.
I'd only want to ask him one question. Why? My parents could have given him anything. Why would he just shoot them?
He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce.
Was invincible. Sadly, he was mistaken.
I can't picture him as a criminal, not the kind I deal with.
In that moment, he was simply your father.
I love that movie. Saw it countless times at that theater. How long did it play there?
Only when you wanted to see it, Bruce. Your mother arranged the special screenings personally.
I never knew that. She was always so good to me.
Where exactly does the memory end?
With my father pleading, "You don't have to do this." And the gun fires.
And after that? There are considerable gaps in that recollection.
Maybe. Do I really want to know? They were assassinated. And Carmine Falcone knows why.
Getting you in to see Falcone like this, I don't have to tell you how many rules we're breaking. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm always here for you, but this could land us both in hot water. I pulled all the strings I had with the lieutenant. This better not come back to bite us.
Look, I get that, Harv, okay? And it means a lot to me.
I know it does, Bruce. It doesn't make it any easier. The last time we brushed shoulders with Falcone, the press made us pay. At least tell me what this is about. Look, I'm all for blind support, but I should at least know what I'm getting myself into.
I'm not sure, but I think Falcone put a hit on my parents.
Wait, what? Bruce, that's terrible.
That's why I have to speak with him. I have to know for sure.
Bruce, I appreciate you opening up to me, but just try and keep it cool in there. I don't want any headlines taking away from my debate with Hill.
Gentlemen, we finally put Falcone in his cage. Now, thanks to the information you gave me, Bruce, he won't ever get out.
Whoa, I'm sorry. Information? What information?
Oh, I assumed you knew. I was going to contact your office first thing, but everything's been a little busy.
I gave him some evidence against Falcone.
More like a catalog of his entire criminal empire. It's a case that'll put Falcone away for life.
Is that a fact?
It's the reason I said yes to this unorthodox request.
Nice job bringing in Falcone.
Yeah, that son of a bitch better not get off again.
He's not getting off the hook, Renee. Not this time.
Mr. Wayne, Sergeant Renee Montoya.
I just wanted to say, you know, some of us police support you, despite what the media is saying.
Thanks, Sergeant.
We're keeping Falcone in the infirmary. He's lucky he didn't get roughed up more. I could tell Batman wanted to kill him, but he held back. He cares about doing the right thing.
Well, whoever he is behind that mask, I say Gotham's lucky to have him.
Yeah, it's great to know he's out there watching over the city.
All right, Falcone's inside. Say what you gotta say. We'll be out here.
Bruce Wayne? You must have some clout. My own wife can't get in to see me. Good thing I'll be out of here in a week.
We need to talk, Falcone.
You weren't so eager the last time we met. But then, I knew you'd come around. Especially after the press got their teeth into you. You're your father's son. Yeah, that's right. Tommy and I were close. More than friends. More like cousins. Going back decades.
Did you have something to do with his death?
Ah, so that's what this is really about, eh? The pup digging up a 20-year-old killer.
Two killings. And they were never forgotten.
You and me, we're practically family. I thought you'd have figured that out by now. I tried to get through to you at Dent's party. You showed me the door. Got a whole closet full of birthday presents I was never able to give you.
We are not family, Falcone. I'm nothing like you.
If you're anything like Thomas Wayne, then we're not so different. Your father, Hill, and me, we ran this city. Still do. God damn this pain. Can't think through it. Morphine's on the side there. Be a good boy and help Uncle Carmine out, huh? I keep my veins clean of any of that gunk. But you never forget the tender kiss. It'd be so easy to give me the whole vial, wouldn't it? Enough there to put an old dog down forever. Of course, you'd never know the whole story. How much of your parents do you have in you? What kind of son did Thomas Wayne make?
I'm not a murderer.
No, you're not. That's why you were kept in the dark. Much better, kid. Thank you. Just you like that reminds me of your mother. Your father may have been the doctor, but Martha, she had the human touch. Think you got more of her in you, tell the truth. Yeah, there's a kindness in you. You care about people. Even mean old bastards like me.
Don't you dare talk about my mother.
Hey, why not, kid? I got nothing but good things to say about her. She was the only one that ever had a hold on your father.
Until you hired an assassin to kill them both.
What, you really think I hired Chill? Sure. I worked with Joe Chill from time to time. Put a button on someone, he'd take him out. But I never ordered that hit on your parents.
So who did?
You can't trust anyone in Gotham. Least of all those you call friend. Your parents learned that.
They're waiting for you in hell! The bastard had to die.
Hands in the air!
Stand down! Get a doctor! Secure this floor! No one gets in or out! Go! Go!
Shit. I bought us some time, but not much. Word's gonna get out, sooner or later. Why would she do something like this? We had Gotham's biggest crime lord in our grasp. This close, we were this close.
I don't know. I hardly recognized her when she burst in. She was so different from the woman we met in the hall.
It's a disgrace. Another officer gone rogue.
Just doesn't make any sense. She'd never do anything to hurt the department.
Falcone's case meant justice for 1,000 unnamed victims. And now it is a PR disaster. How can I run against corruption when our own cops are redecorating the precinct with their prisoners' brains? Listen, we gotta get out in front of this. We gotta spin it as best we can. Issue a statement saying that we have the shooter in custody. Details are still coming in and that we're investigating. The usual.
Slow down, Harvey. We need the facts first.
The simple fact is she walked in and shot him.
Then we need the complex facts, like how and why.
Lieutenant, Mr. District Attorney, Falcone's lawyers are here.
Oh, Christ. I can delay them for a little while, but we still need answers.
Tell me if she says anything. I have to know why she did this.
Alfred, Falcone's been murdered.
Good God. I'm looking into it, but I'll need access to the back computer for anything I find.
Connection secured.
Alfred, I'm gonna try and confirm some suspicions of mine. Her veins, still visible beneath her skin. Fresh injection site. That doesn't look like blood. Alfred, I think I found the substance. Analyze and forward me the result.
Of course. I'll be in touch as soon as I have the results.
Where am I? Mr. Wayne? What's going on? Oh, but I got this awful feeling something terrible happened.
Sergeant, you have to think. What do you remember?
Oh, God. Falcone. I was hoping it wasn't real.
I believe you were drugged, Sergeant.
It would explain a lot. Listen, you have to believe me. I talk big about hurting thugs like Falcone, but I would never, never betray the lieutenant. Everything is so foggy. I remember a sharp pain.
There's an injection site on your neck.
Then I just felt light, like I could do whatever I wanted. No guilt, no consequence. There was a voice in my ear insisting Falcone was gonna get off. And all I knew was that I had to stop that. I had to, no matter what. The reasons why I shouldn't, they were a million miles away.
Did you see a face? Could you ID a suspect?
I don't think so.
You must remember some detail. Try.
I remember a hand on my arm, guiding me. Like a parent with a child. The voice, it was saying something about revolution.
Cobblepot said something similar.
I'm so sorry, Lieutenant. I've let you down.
We stalled Falcone's lawyers for now, but they'll be back. So how is she? Did she tell you anything?
Yeah, don't worry about that now.
I found evidence that she was drugged. A fresh injection site on her neck.
I was out of my mind, Lieutenant. Please believe me.
Hey, I do. Of course I do.
Hey, get forensics in here. Now!
She remembers a voice saying something about revolution.
That's not much to go on.
Now, if you're bringing forensics in, let's get Bruce out.
Alfred, I gotta get back to the manor. I've got a lead on whoever's behind this.
Bruce! What are you doing here? My friends in the GCPD have been telling stories about some kind of lockdown?
I'm sorry, Vicky. I don't have time.
Don't brush me off. Word is there were shots fired near where Falcone was being held. Know anything about that? I mean, you must have been back there when it happened.
Where did you get that?
So it's true?
No, I didn't say that.
Word is, you turned over enough dirt on Falcone to put him in Blackgate prison for life. A day after he showed up at your house. And now you're here. You can't afford to be associated with another scandal. I can keep your name out of whatever we print, but you need to give me something I can use. Who fired the shots? A cop? I can tell by the way you're brushing me off that something happened. Just give me something to run with.
Please, get out of my way, Vicky. I'm in a hurry.
Huh. Disappointing. Maybe you have more to do with this than I thought.
Thank you.
Either Cobblepot drugged Montoya himself, or someone else is using his revolutionary rhetoric.
Either way, I need to find him. Let's put our drones in the air and start a search.
I'll run a trace on his cell. In the meantime, we have to find out what we can do about this drug.
The computer's been analyzing the chemicals from Montoya's bloodstream.
Throw that up on the monitor. The residue I scan on Montoya is similar to the nerve agent I found at the docks. Let's see what we got.
It's ironic that Falcone died at the hands of someone drugged with his chemicals. Who'd have guessed that's how he'd meet his maker? Prone in his sickbed, surrounded by police who were ordered to protect him.
Murder at the hands of Montoya. That's not justice.
Whoever did this was judge, jury, and executioner. No one should act as all three. I hope he told you something before he was killed. What did you learn from him?
Practically family, he said.
Family? Funny, I don't recall any Sunday dinners with the mob.
It wasn't Falcone who called the hit.
Yes, well, I suppose that makes sense. Your father, Hill, and Falcone would have balanced each other out.
Computers pinpointed reference points on the two compounds. The men at the docks were doused with the base chemicals. The reaction was messy. They were out of control. This refined drug is like a weapon. It only took a small injection to strip Montoya of her moral filters and make her act on her base impulses. Both compounds seem stable, but they're quick to fall apart. Whoever processed it knew what they were doing.
What could the creators of such a drug possibly have in mind? Fighting your wars is one thing, but drugging others to fight them for you? Oh.
With this drug, they can exploit anyone's baser impulses, the things they would otherwise control.
Your drones are in position to triangulate Cobblepot's location.
For Falcone's body to get cold, did you, Oz?
Going to speak with him, Bruce?
Bruce Wayne already tried talking with Cobblepot. It's time he met the Batman.
Ever again.
You lot, come check out this office.
Where is
he? I don't know! Please!
Come on! James! You can help me.
Let him go.
Batman! It's about time! You kill a crime boss, you'd expect a word of thanks from Gotham's number one vigilante. Oh, don't worry, I'll pass your gratitude on to those who made it happen. They'll be pleased to know you think so highly of their work.
I said let him go.
You hear that, Roland? That sounded like an order.
I'll crush him.
Now, have a little respect for the Bat. Think he underestimates you. Is this about Falcone? We all saw how you felt about Falcone. Pounded him into a pulp on live TV. If you were truly the defender of this city, you'd have finished the job yourself. Admit it, Falcone deserved to die. Vermin like Falcone, they deserve to be stomped out. Believe me, I know.
You don't decide who lives and who dies. That's not justice.
But it's bloody well satisfying, isn't it? As a show of good faith, I'm gonna let this one go. How's about we talk this through? We helped you with Falcone. Now, if we could just cut out the rest of the rot, like Wayne and Hill, ordinary folks might be able to breathe.
Oswald Cobblepot. What is it about this place that attracts criminal scum like you?
Gotta admit, you've got flair. Here's the thing. I actually admire you, Batman. We both want the same kinds of things. Me and my people, we've got big plans for Gotham.
They found Catwoman.
What do you want with her?
We had a deal. She didn't make good on it. So sorry this didn't work out, mate. I'd stay to watch. I would, but I still got a Catwoman problem to deal with. Oh, what's her name again?
Selina.
Yes! Oh, beautiful name.
Track down Selina Kyle.
I'll find her right away.
You lost? Because I don't have time for tourists. Looks like you walked into the wrong bar.
Yeah, I'm looking for a woman.
You wouldn't be the first.
Selina Kyle, I'm told she practically lives here.
Selina, huh? You don't strike me as her type.
You'd be surprised.
Hey, don't I know you? It is you. Knew it. Cops take all your fancy clothes? Or you trying to lay low? Of course, you're not really the low-lying type.
Nice to meet you.
Frank. Yeah.
Funny seeing you here. So much in the papers. Whole other thing, meeting the man in real life. You're shorter than I thought you would be.
Leave him alone, Frank. Man's just trying to have a quiet drink.
He didn't seem to mind the company. Whatever.
Selena, I need to tell you something important.
Better be an apology. You were supposed to take care of our mutual problem. Instead, you just pissed him off.
That's why I'm here. You're in danger.
I've had rats on my tail all day.
The man who hired you, his name is Oswald Cobblepot.
Never heard of him.
He goes by Penguin.
Penguin? Shit. Ugh, you've got to be kidding me. You should have just killed me on that rooftop. I'm dead anyway. When you screw someone over, you really screw them. The Penguin.
I'm going to deal with it. But I need you to tell me everything you know about him.
I only know him by reputation. I'm surprised you never heard of him. He's a big deal across the pond. He's more dangerous than you think. You don't know what you're getting into.
I can take him.
I appreciate confidence in a man, but not stupidity. The question is, why Gotham? Why now? It's not like he's hurting for crime syndicates abroad. Why leave that?
Oswald wanted Falcone out of the picture. Looks like he succeeded.
So what? He wants to take his place?
Maybe. For starters.
Well, I'm not sticking around here to find out.
Oswald... Penguin is about to unleash God knows what on the city. You can't just leave.
A good reason not to be here when he does. You want to stay? That's your choice.
I need you, Selena.
That right?
If Penguin is as deadly as you say, I need all the help I can get.
Bruce, sweetie, the gallant knight thing, it really is adorable. But what would Harvey think? The two of us, working together. After all, I'm not really an all work and no play kind of girl. Harvey knows that.
Keep Harvey out of this. The less he knows, the safer he'll be.
I'm sure his safety is your paramount concern. You and I...
Get out of the way!
Please, don't wreck my bar.
Well, Bruce, you were right.
Selena Kyle, Penguin says hello. Beat it. We're here for her. If you care about your own skin, you'll get the hell out.
She's with me. I think you need to leave.
Not done yet.
I think they want more.
Then let's give it to them.
Pretty good for such a pretty boy. Come on, this way.
Check the other side.
Are we alone?
Yeah, we're alone.
Let's get out of here. I'll take the rooftops. You take the alley.
Wait. When will I see you again?
When you least expect it. You shouldn't trust me, you know.
Alfred, I'm uploading the contents of a smartphone to the back computer. Check to see if there's anything on the phone we can use.
Processing it now. Is everything all right? There are quite a few police cars convening on your location.
It's fine. Has the back computer found anything yet?
Bruce, there are a number of messages here. All from Mayor Hill.
Mayor Hill?
The last voicemail is his. Listen to this.
I gave you everything I have on Wayne. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
This is very shady indeed. Whatever they're talking about, it doesn't sound good.
I should have guessed. Hill's working with Penguin. If Hill's talking to Penguin, he must know something. It's time I paid him a visit.
I agree. The mayor must have answers, but if I may offer a word of advice... People look up to Batman after how you handled Falcone. Terrorizing the mayor could damage that goodwill. Then again, Batman's methods would certainly get him talking immediately. Bruce would have to depend on his guile to loosen Hill's lips.
Going as Bruce is the smart choice.
Sorry, the mayor's busy. Do you have an appointment? The mayor's doing debate prep. He really can't be disturbed right now.
Well, I was really hoping you'd be able to help me out. Who knows, maybe I could return the favor one day.
It seems you do have an appointment, Mr. Wayne. Silly me.
Bruce Wayne? Finally, you've come to see me. Of course, only after your name's been dragged through the mud. Don't get me wrong, I'm glad to see you. But you're a day late and a great many dollars short.
We can be friends, Hill. I'd like us to put aside our differences.
It's easy to ask for peace when you've already lost the war. But I won't be the one to deny a fresh start. Your father and I, we took this city and made it ours. Falcone too, rest his soul. We built everything we have. You were born with it. A young man like you wouldn't understand what it takes to rise to the top.
Oh, I understand. Very well.
I gave you everything I have on Wayne. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
Sounds like me.
It is you.
So, what's your point? I take it you have one. Or are you just fond of my dulcet tones?
I'm here as a friend. This can disappear.
Oh, let me guess. There's a fee.
The fee is full disclosure on your partners.
Partners? I want nothing to do with it. I'm in Cobblepot's crosshairs, same as you.
But you fed them dirt on me.
Only the files I seized from Wayne Manor. Your father, Falcone, and I, we had ways of getting anything we wanted. How do you think your family got the land for Wayne Tower? Cobblepot wants retribution because we took his family's land. Oswald's family signed it over to us, along with the rest of their assets.
If that's true, maybe I can make it right.
Noble, but naive. It was so long ago, there's nothing left of the Cobblepot estate. Maybe if I could count on you as an ally, I could use the powers of my office to help you make reparations. There's so much more I could share, if only we were friends. I could help you deal with Penguin, let you in on some family history. But I'm caught in a dogfight for my political career, and my rival has bottomless pockets. Now, if that rival were to, say, drop out, or his advertising spend were to dry up, I might have a lot more resources for helping a new friend.
Not a chance, Hill. I'm not cutting Harvey loose.
Well, you dropped on your head. When the mayor of Gotham extends a hand, you take it.
I don't need your hand. Not with your voice on tape.
You forget who you're talking to. I'm the man that says I never left such and such a message. And all the judges bow their heads and say, yes, sir. I'm the man who sends the police to your house to take your things, and I give them to whoever I please. You're nothing like your father. You'd never have the backbone to do what we did. I'm the heavyweight, Wayne, and you're punching above your weight. Get out of the ring before you get hurt.
I would never stoop so low. My backbone doesn't have the bend.
Let me put it this way. If that voicemail makes it to the papers, or anywhere else I don't like, I'll turn my commissioner loose on your lieutenant for that fiasco down at the precinct.
Gordon?
And then I'll turn him on you and Dent for being there. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a debate to prep for. Get him out of here.
Whatever deal you made with Penguin, he won't honor it.
Don't worry about me. You should watch your own back.
Alfred, get a warning to Gordon. Tell him to increase security at the debate. Hill seems to think he's safe, but Penguin's still out there. I wonder what else is on here.
As per your request, Lieutenant Gordon has tripled security at the debate.
Thanks, Alfred.
It's a plan of the old Monarch Theater.
The auditorium where the debate's being held. I hacked into the image feeds from the security cameras at the auditorium.
Just to be safe.
Just to be safe.
Hills, details about your father.
It must have been quite upsetting. I can't imagine how you must feel. To learn so much in so little time.
To hear their crimes detailed, first by a Falcone, then by a snake like Hill. It makes me question myself.
You shouldn't, Bruce. You are your own man. And the city needs you, now more than ever. I'll leave you to it then.
Mr. Gotham's dive bar.
Wait a minute. The images on these cameras haven't changed. Something's wrong.
Penguin's men may have commandeered the cameras on their end. We could just be looking at
what they want us to see. Warn Gordon that he may have visitors. I have to get down there. Now. Harvey needs to get out of there.
Hey, Bruce. Man, I'm glad you called. I needed to talk to you, actually. Something's come up. Something that's... well, it's not exactly pleasant.
Why? What happened? Are you all right?
Me? Oh, yeah,
I'm fine. Oh, you mean because of this Penguin threat? They have me in some back room until the debate begins.
For my own protection, they said. A little bit of overkill, if you ask me. Look.
Bruce, I didn't want to do this over the phone, but...
my advisors are telling me that I need to... distance myself from you. Until all this mess with your family blows over. They're afraid
it... I get it. It's the smart move, but let's talk about that later.
I'm glad you see it that way.
What with the allegations in the press, and now this mess with Falcone, you're a liability. But here's the thing, Bruce.
Without your money...
I am dead in the water. I know this is a delicate topic, but I need you to keep me afloat.
I may have to trash you in public, but you and me, we'll know the truth about our friendship.
No matter what, we need a new mayor. Hill needs to be removed.
I knew you'd see it that way.
Listen, I hate to push
you, but I need to know. Can I count on your money, Bruce?
Whatever it takes to save Gotham, that's what we wanted.
I'll always support you, Harvey.
Oh, thank you, Bruce. Thank you. You don't know how much this means to me. To Gotham. I'm sorry, Bruce. The makeup person is here. Guess she needs to put on my face.
I hope you can still watch the debate somewhere. No matter what I have to say tonight, remember.
You are always my friend.
Batman.
Yeah, all quiet so far.
I've got a feeling that's about to change.
I'm glad I took a chance on this collaboration of ours. Keep on doing what you're doing, and the rest of Gotham will start to see you like I do. A hero.
Hero is a lofty title. I hope I live up to it.
Could be tonight's the night to prove it.
We have bigger things to worry about right now. Your security has been compromised.
I've got patrols on every door.
You better check on them.
I'd keep that holstered if I were you.
What's she doing here? She was part of that robbery at the mayor's office.
Really? You're gonna drag out that dead horse?
We're all on the same side, Jim.
Well, this better not come back to bite me. Alpha Patrol, come in.
That, incident in the bar. Dead is its own kind of cage. I can't stand being in it. Not that I needed your help or anything, but you had my back. I thought I'd repay the favor. You know, like you scratch my back, I cut some people up.
Doing the right thing. Maybe there's hope for you yet.
Don't read too much into it. I'm just allergic to owing you anything.
None of my men on the ground are responding.
Enough waiting. We're going in.
Alpha, do you read?
Now aren't you glad I'm here?
Now you have a better shot than my SWAT team of getting in there quietly.
We are seriously underfunded at the GCPD.
Sounds like a vote for Dent, Lieutenant.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our live debate with the next mayor of Gotham City. This is an important debate for these two candidates, incumbent Mayor Hamilton Hill and the challenger, Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent. And it's also important for you, the citizens of Gotham, who will soon head to the polls to decide the future of your home, a city that's faced its share of hardships in recent years. Income inequality, yes, a massive vigilante groups on our streets. Candidates will tackle it all.
We know why they weren't responding.
Gordon, we found one of your patrols. They've been terminated.
Oh, those goddamn
sons of... Sorry, ladies and gents. As you might have guessed, there's been a change to tonight's program. First order of business, firing the moderator!
I hate to be a downer, but these hostages, I don't like their chances.
They just didn't have a head for the issues.
If we're quick and decisive, no one else has to die.
If you say so. But Penguin's playing for keeps.
Fanatics always do.
You'll do. Get out here. Keep it quiet back there.
These guys are armed to the teeth.
We need a new moderator.
Come on, you.
You there. Yes! You! Thank you for volunteering!
Please! No!
Go on, then! Introduce the candidates! Stage fright, huh? All right, I'll get you started. But this is your show.
Three hostiles. Gotta take them out quietly.
Smart.
Heads.
Questions. Ask him questions.
Mr. Dent, the subject on everyone's mind is the new Wayne Mental Health Facility.
It's much needed. State of the art mental health care. Hospital for all, but for treatment for the most unfortunate of Gotham citizens.
Your heads down. Make for the police line.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
My downtrodden brothers and sisters of Gotham, you have nothing to fear. We are the children of Arkham. We are here to end the masquerade and expose the corruption that ruined your city. For too long, men like your esteemed mayor have profited from the pain of innocence.
I knew this was too big for Oswald alone. Someone else is pulling the strings.
Smart. Let someone else do the dirty work.
Look into the hearts of these spineless creatures. Chosen to
go
be.
On, love. You know what to do.
Moderator gets shot on live TV. What's going on in there?
First off, we should incinerate the pool.
Gotham's flawed. Sure. Let's say he isn't.
We're out of time, Batman! The brass is going nuts with those two drunk on stage!
It is not too late to save the city. Corrupt politicians!
And what about the corrupt elite? The men's fortunes are built on corpses! Men like your friend, Bruce Wayne! You're as bad as he is! Happy to look away! You don't want to see. Roll the tape!
Subject 9.
Dad.
I thought your father was dead.
Subject 9. Esther Cobblepot. You've been declared criminally insane and committed to Arkham indefinitely as a ward of the state.
Please, I'll sell you the land. Please don't do this.
You had your chance. You should have made the deal we offered you. Give her the drug.
Thomas, we're friends. Our boys play together.
You were warned, Esther. You know I always get what I want. Commence the procedure. Give her a dose she won't come back from.
Now you know. Now you will see!
Batman! You certainly know how to make an entrance! Why don't you kick the crap out of here?
No, please, I made an end.
You could never.
That was awesome. Wait, not me. I took out Thomas Wayne. That was all him. He didn't know when to stop. I had him killed because of it.
There won't bring back my poor old mum. So this is for her.
You won't let her kill anyone else.
Wait your turn, Dent. Where's your mate, Bruce Wayne, your biggest supporter, and he didn't even turn up. Batman! The revolution's already started! It's too late to join!
Let Dent go!
And what if I don't?
I'll crush every bone in your body.
I knew you'd say something like that.
City Hall is in chaos after Mayor Hamilton Hill was confirmed dead.
While several members of the Children of Arkham have been arrested, the Penguin is still at large.
He won't be the same after this.
Meanwhile, the Wayne family scandal continued to escalate after the full list of Thomas Wayne's victims was released to the public. Representing Bruce Wayne have no comment at this time.
We are the Children of Arkham, and we have opened your eyes.
Next time on Batman, the Telltale series.
You may have saved me, but this isn't over. You don't know these people, Bruce.
Authorities are scrambling. The so-called Children of Arkham have the city in a frenzy, but there's still no sign of their masked leader. With Hill and Falcone dead by their hands, the question on everyone's lips is, who's next?
After that news about your father sending innocent people to Arkham, sounds like the whole city wants your head on a pike.
The Waynes have always run this company, but now they want to decide what your future at this company will be.
Do you really think Bruce Wayne is worth protecting?
What do you want from me?
You know what I want.
No more hiding, not for anyone.
But don't worry. Bruce Wayne's finally gonna get what's coming to him.
Bruce!